Module 1, Part 4, Power BI Overview. Hello, my name is Peter Myers, and in this video I'll demonstrate how to prepare Power BI content. The first thing that I'm going to do is create a workspace, and the intention of this workspace is to store the content that I intend to embed in my app. Here in the Power BI service, I click on Workspaces in the navigation pane, and then I click the button to create a workspace. In the Create a Workspace pane, in the Workspace Name box, I enter a name for the workspace, Sales Reports. Then I simply click Save. Now that the workspace is created, in the URL I notice the unique identifier for that workspace. I go ahead then and copy it, and then switch to my settings, and then I paste it for future reference when I'm about to develop my app. Now back in the Power BI service at the bottom left, I click Get Data. And this allows me then to import a file from my local file system. I then select the Sales Analysis Report, and then I click Open. This uploads the file to the workspace, resulting in the creation of both a dataset and a report. I now go ahead and click on the Sales Analysis Report, and let's take a look at what the report looks like. This regional sales analysis report includes three slices along the top. Notice how I can easily use the dropdown and filter by a different year. I could also filter by region, and I can filter by product category. This is a great example of an analytical report. It provides high-level summary and contextual details. There are also three tabs allowing me to explore sales decomposition, sales map, and sales trends. The decomposition tree allows me to explore and dig deeper into the data. The sales map provides a geospatial representation of the data. So by hovering over a state like California, I see additional details. In fact, this is an example of a report page tooltip. Lastly, the Sales Trend tab provides me additional perspective, including a column line chart showing me the monthly sales and with commentary provided by a smart narrative. So that I'll have two reports to embed, let me now go ahead and create a second report. So in the navigation pane, I expand the Sales Reports workspace, and then I click on the Sales Analysis dataset. I then click to create a report from scratch. I'm going to keep this report design very simple. In the Visualizations pane, I click the Map Visual icon to add a map visual to the page, and then I resize it to fill the entire page. In the Fields pane, I expand the State table and check the State field, so it will group by state, and then I expand the Sales table and select the Sales field to summarize by sales. If I then hover over a state like California, a tooltip reveals the sales for that state. To save this report, I'll click Save at the top right, and then I'll name this report the Sales Map. And now contained within my workspace, I can see that I have two reports, Sales Analysis and Sales Map, and these reports will be embedded into the app later on.